My name is Cindy Clow. I'm with the Plymouth Public Library and One Book, One City. And we are here today outside of Heartland Artist Gallery. My name is Cindy Clow, and I work at the Plymouth Library, but we are with One Book, One City, and Anna Kleisman has actually been really instrumental, too, in One Book, One City, but there's more to Anna, and so this is why we're here today. Anna, what brought you back to Plymouth? Because you were in Plymouth, right?
That's right. I was born and raised in Plymouth, and I graduated from Plymouth High School in 1996. And then after that, I went to school in Wisconsin and kind of worked my way back down south. I lived in Chicago for, 6 years maybe, and then my husband and I moved to Valparaiso, and then we found ourselves back in Plymouth after my father retired and my husband took over his business here. So we brought our kids back here to Plymouth and have been here now for 10 years.
Wow, that's fabulous.
I know. Can't believe it's been 10 years. So, yeah. So, being back here has been, it's been interesting to be gone for so many years and then to come back, but definitely happy to be here.
One of the other questions that, you know, I thought about too is that I know whether it's photography or you just have such an artistic flair, where did that passion come from? When did it start?
So I guess my passion for art started when I was very young. My mom was an artist when I was a kid. She had an advertising company here in town. And so I grew up in her studio, grew up watching her create all these designs for, you know, different businesses in town. And so usually it was me sitting in her studio with a box of markers or some of her leftover art supplies. And so we just kind of grew up in a very, my sister and I both grew up in a very creative household. And so we, you know, anything from, you know, coloring and, you know, painting to lots of jewelry making and some pottery and things like that. So we just grew up in a really creative household. So I didn't have much of a choice, but that's okay. Cause you know, I certainly love it. I love art.
One of the other questions, Kay, you were talking about you grew up with it. Do you feel like you had that talent like right off the bat, or do you know what I'm saying? I mean, you can tell.
Well, I think it's interesting because, you know, as you kind of grow and you learn and you experience art in, you know, so many different ways, seeing other artists, putting your own artwork out there. I never thought that art was going to kind of be my, you know, part of my, I don't want to call it a career necessarily, but I guess it kind of is. I never thought I would find myself here. I was in education for a while. I had a psych degree. But there was always art kind of in my life, at, you know, in some capacity. But I don't know that I mean, I don't know. I guess I kind of knew that I was always kind of creative. I don't know that I would necessarily say I had all these different talents, but I felt like I was a very creative person my whole life. And so I definitely channeled that creativity when I taught school, because I taught fourth and sixth grade for a handful of years, and you know, all the different things, you know, just kind of pulling all different sorts of, artistic, creative techniques and media and things like that. So it's always been there. It's just now it's taken a whole different life of its own since I've been at the gallery.
You were talking about different mediums. So I know that you have this beautiful picture. So photography is one.
I love photography. I think that it's one of those things that, especially today, you know, we have so much technology that allows us to take a picture wherever we are, to take a photograph or to capture a memory. So I love that. I love where technology has gone with photography, but I also still have my film camera at home that I got when I graduated from high school. And I became really interested in photography when I was a teenager. And then, of course, you know, kind of stopped doing it for a few years and then you pick it back up again, kind of like a lot of different hobbies and interests that people have. So, you know, when it came to like getting an iPhone, like that was just so fun because you could edit the photos right there in your hands, mm-hmm. you know, there, and then there's all these different apps that you can use and it's fun, you know. But so photography was great. I have a couple iPhone photography pieces in this show right now. But I also, one thing that I got really interested in, and this was right when we moved back to Plymouth, was paper arts, and in particular quilling, which is taking long strips of paper and turning them around as a needle or something like that, and then you can create all these different shapes and different designs. And so I started doing that for friends who were getting married, having children, and you know making monograms and things like that. So that was something that I got interested in about, you know, 10 or 15 years ago. So I still love doing it. I did a really big piece for the Reese Theater fundraiser a couple years ago, and it's a really time-consuming process. So time has not been
something I've had busy.
Lately. I'm hoping to get back into it again soon.
You got a lot of irons in the fire.
Yeah, yeah.
Between family and sports and
all the things. So like anybody, you know, we're all just trying to manage our time as best as we can, but you know, at the same time, trying to find those little times to be creative. I love graphic design. That's something that I've sort of gotten into a little bit more. Technology has allowed that to happen and do it quickly.
Yeah.
My mom talks to me all the time about when she was doing her advertising business and trying to create, you know, logos and designs, and she would have to hand cut, you know, all the either vinyl or lettering and things like that. And here we are just copy paste, and you know, it's a different world. So yeah.
It reminds me, because my mom is actually more artistic. I don't know where that gene went with me, but I might have missed. I remember her cutting things out and stuff. Mm-hmm. I want to go back to your, I have a couple questions. First of all, okay, you said you had the camera with the old film and stuff. Did mm-hmm. you develop it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I did not develop it myself. It was definitely, we sent it to Walgreens. To a camera, you know, place. There was a great one in Warsaw that we would use. But yeah, no, I didn't. That was one thing I kind of missed it, you know, mm-hmm. like when I would have been old enough to learn how to develop the photos. That's right when, you know, the DSLRs came in, the digital photography, all the digital cameras. Really kind of took center stage, and that's fun because again, it's instant gratification, right? We got it so quickly. But I still, like I said, I still have my film camera. My niece, who's she's in early college, she's kind of really interested in film camera. Like a lot of these young people are interested in some of these things that are old, all, you know, everything that's old is new again.
Mm-hmm.
And so we've talked a little bit about that, but I think it's cool that the young people are seeing some of the value of some of these older forms of photography and older art forms.
Question for you. Do you have any of your quilling here? You don't have like an example here?
I don't have an example here.
I'm just really curious.
Yeah, you know, actually there's probably one of our bookmarks somewhere that might have like a little image on there, but I haven't. I'm trying to think of even the last time I've created something. It's been about a year. I have lots of works in progress. You know, I'm probably like many artists, great at starting, terrible at finishing. Life just gets in the way sometimes. So yeah,
absolutely.
But I hope to have something up here pretty soon. I keep saying one of our shows, I'm going to enter something, but then I end up organizing the show, and that's a lot of time. So you know, but it's okay. One of these days.
Seasons. It's like there's seasons.
Exactly.
Another thing too is that you are not only talented, but you have quite a pulse right here at Heartland Artists. So what was it that brought you here? Like, how did the doors open?
Well, it's really interesting because as much as I have kind of a just more of a recreational artistic background, I don't have an academic art background. I didn't go to art school. Like I said earlier, psychology degree and an education degree. When we moved back here, My mother was asked to join the board here at the Heartland Artists, and she was like, well, my plate's already full, but my daughter just moved back here. Let me see if she would be interested. And so, I took a board position, got to learn about the gallery a little bit and got involved in some of the committees and some of our events. And then I, you know, just sort of evolved a couple years later that, kind of took on some leadership positions, and then they asked if I would be interested in becoming the president. And so, of course, I thought about it for a little while. But, you know, we have such a great, we had a great board, we have a great board, and we have such great members here who are just, we're a co-op, so, you know, everyone has kind of a service or a job to do. So I knew that whatever I got into, you know, there's going to be a tremendous amount of support.
There are different, like, different rooms. So is there, like themes that you have in the different rooms?
So if you come into the gallery, you'll see that, yeah, we have these different partitions that kind of come from the front to the back. So where we're standing right now with this white wall, this is what we consider our featured artist wall, basically this. And then on the other side, where you can see from the window from the sidewalk. That this wall changes every month. So this month we're hosting the home exhibit, the home themed exhibit, which is part of the One Book One City community-wide event. And so everything that's up here right now was created by members of Marshall County. And some of these people who created these artworks are not necessarily artists. This was open to the whole community to submit a piece of work that, you know, was their interpretation of the theme home. So if you come in and you see, you'll see things that do literally look, you know, like home, and some are really creative, different interpretations of what that means. So it's really kind of cool to come in and see. So we even have, we kind of categorized it emerging artists, master artists, and then collaborative artists. And so we have some folks up here who consider themselves emerging. They're learning. Maybe they're not, you know, they're not entering lots of shows. They don't necessarily display their work a lot. They're learning, it's taking classes. So we have kind of a mix of that. You can see we have some young people up here too, which is so fun, Grandpa's Tractor. And then of course we have our master artists up here, as you can see some. And so it's kind of cool to have them hanging together. And then of course, it's actually on the other side of the wall, but we have a couple collaborative groups. The Plymouth Parks Department came together and did a really cool looking piece. And then the museum, the Marshall County Historical Society, did a really, really cool piece that was collaborative as well. So, you know, this is our first one, our first community show. So I was really pleased. We had over 30 pieces of artwork.
This is wonderful.
In all the categories and a variety of media. So this turned out really, really well. Yeah. So this is the featured artist section. Anything beyond it. Oh, sorry.
No, that's good. I was just looking at that. It's just, you have to come in.
Yeah, it's really fun. And everything is just so different, which, you know, that's how it is. Everything beyond this white wall, on the maroon walls, in the you can see the different partitions. Those are our member artists, and we have, I keep telling myself I need to get an updated count, but we have roughly 30, I believe, member artists who actively are displaying their work. So anything from painting, so acrylics, watercolor, oils, we have resin, we have enamel, we have pottery, we have jewelry, photography, I mean, you name it, the mediums are there, stained glass, which is really fun. And then of course we have a couple classrooms, so we offer classes in pretty much all of the different media that we have here. So,
absolutely.
Yeah.
And then I saw two giant blueberries back there.
Yes. Yeah. So we have taken over the Blueberries in Marshall County program, which are the big blueberry sculptures that we can find around town. actually around Marshall County, and our local businesses will sponsor those blueberries, and then we'll place them in different places around town. And so we're working on two blueberries right now. We're working on one for Zentis. And these are in progress. And so we're painting them here. Our member artists can come in and they can, you know, they kind of, it's a really cool cooperative activity that we have for our members. And so they all come together and they paint them. And so you can see how they progress. So yeah, they're both coming along really, really well. The other one is for us. We're replacing our old blueberry. So they're really, they're cool. And the different themes that the blueberries have are, you know, they're exciting to see, like, all the different creative ideas that the different people have had.
How can I say that? Who designs, like, each blueberry? Does the company come up with the ideas? Mm-hmm. Do you come up with the ideas and say, hey, you want to try this? How do you do it?
Yes and yes. So it's up to the sponsor. It's up to the company. If they want to have some creative input or all the creative input, sometimes the company will be like, have at it, artists. You guys know what you're doing. But we did one for Lincoln Junior High School, and the kids, you know, they had all the, you know, at least not most of the creative input in what was going to go on their blueberry, which they should. So it kind of just depends. We work, you know, pretty closely with each sponsor or business so that they get what they want. Yeah, we just did one for, it was recently installed, but U.S. Granules sponsored a blueberry for the high school baseball field. And so it's a blueberry that looks like a baseball. It was a simple one, but, you know, that's what they wanted. They wanted it simple. And so that's what we delivered. Yeah.
So when you see the blueberries around town.
Yes. Most of them, well, I shouldn't say most, they've been around for, I think, like 6 or 7 years at this point. Don't quote me on that. But that was started off with a couple different artists. Sometimes the Heartland artists would have been involved. But that maybe the last 4 or 5 blueberries have been just us. So
you have to, it's Nixon Field, right?
Yes.
So checking out Nixon Field so you guys can see the great big
baseball. Yes, yeah. And then, of course, River Park Square has a couple. They have a golf ball, and then they have one that's covered in quilts, since we have, you know, the quilts in Marshall County. So it's really cool.
Mm-hmm. Right. Something that I really enjoyed. So we were actually here, was it like a week and a day ago? And we were here because it was about being creative, you know, what that means to a community. And we're talking about how important it is that, you know, the service that you're offering, and how important it is, because, you know, art really means so much to different people. So what does art mean to you?
Oh, that's such a big question. I could probably give you a different answer on a different day, depending on, I don't know, how I'm feeling, what I'm doing, what we're doing here. Well, art, you know, art is about expression. Art is about, you know, being, you know, creating something that means something to you. It could be, a message that you want to get across. It could be just, you know, finding something beautiful and wanting to, you know, to create because of that, so, you know, whatever you're inspired by. But it just is about that creative outlet that we all have, regardless but we're all creative in different ways. But yeah, it is about getting that out, and it's about communicating. But then we can take it even further. You know, art is something that causes great conversations to take place. It causes us to question the world around us, and it also brings people together. You know, creativity and art is something that is really, can be very uniting among people, and it allows us to, you know, get to know one another, because it gives us some way to relate to each other. So art, what does it mean to me? I guess it means those things to me today. Yeah. Ask me again tomorrow, I probably could give you a similar but maybe different answer. You find it everywhere. And when you start looking for it and you start seeing it, you start to recognize that, you know, it's all over. So it's everywhere. You can find it anywhere. And everybody has it in them. So we truly believe
that. Okay, so there's hope, right?
Yeah, there's always hope. It doesn't mean you have to draw. It doesn't mean you have to paint. You know, there are just so many, you know, you work in a library. Words and writing and, you know, stories, that's art too. So, yeah. We can,
Something that I was also thinking, and we'll probably, I don't want to take too much of your time, but art is community. And mm-hmm. I really sense that here, like even last week when we were here, mm-hmm. there was a warmth and an inviting. And so for someone who doesn't feel confident in mm-hmm. art, what would you suggest? You know, how can I start? Like even like my, I've got an iPhone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So just what like, because it seems like you have such a great vision of what it should look like. When I'm pointing my camera at something, mm-hmm. What's my focus? What should I? Am I explaining myself?
Yeah. Really? Like how would you approach like improving your iPhone photography? Oh,
yeah.
That's a great question. Well, I guess it kind of depends on what it is that you like to see. What do you like to look at? Find your passion first, you know, mm-hmm. what looks beautiful to you, snap a photo of it. And then, you know, within some of the, you know, the editing that you can do, you know, you can move the picture around, you can crop it, you can learn about the rule of thirds, which is, you know, you can take an image and you break it up into 9 parts, and then your focus really needs to be where there's a series of 4 lines basically, and where they overlap, that's where you need to start looking at your composition. And then of course there's light, and you know, it a lot of it just kind of, you know, you play with it and then you learn. But we have in the past offered iPhone photography classes here, so that would be a great place to start. And now we don't to kind of go, you know, to talk about the classes a little, is that, you know, we're not offering all those classes all the time. So if you ever have any interest in learning a certain medium, even if it is iPhone photography, which we might consider to be like, you know, a very practical kind of mm-hmm. class, because most of us are doing this
right
all the time. You know, if not, we're doing it quite a bit, whether we're taking pictures of our kids or, you know, yeah. at a party, or just we see something cool, you know, on a trip that we've taken or something like that. You know, you can request these classes. You can call us up and say, are you going to be offering this class anytime soon? And we'll be like, well, you know, maybe we will, or, you know, we'll definitely make a note of it and we'll let you know for sure. So our website shows, you know, what classes we're having. Our Facebook page is always showing what classes we're having at the time, but you can message us and call us and request a class. So, yeah, so it's a great way to get started. And then, of course, I always say, if we're not having it, YouTube probably has some good iPhone yeah. photography, you know, little videos or something like that to kind of help you. But, we would always offer those things if we got, you know, certainly enough people who'd be interested.
I think that you'd want to come in person, personally.
We would love
forget
for you
the
to
YouTube.
Come in.
Forget the YouTube.
Yes.
But, Anna, thank you.
Of
thank
course.
You for taking the time.
Hey, yeah.
And you guys, whoever's watching the video, you really, this is just a beautiful, beautiful, wonderful area. And you see this beautiful art, and you see the different mediums mm-hmm. and the resin and the enamel. Okay, I have to admit, I was fascinated by that.
Yeah, yeah.
The pottery.
Resin artist right over there.
That's you bring you in.
Yeah, that's Pat. Yeah, she has
thank
amazing,
you, Pat.
Amazing
that
work.
Was beautiful. Mm-hmm. But come in, the hours, let's talk about your hours.
Yeah, so we are open Tuesdays through Saturdays from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. And then we have our Art in the Street Festival that's coming up at July 31st. So mark your calendars for that. Mm-hmm. That will be right here downtown on Michigan Street. We have art booths, food booths, plenty of family and kids, like hands-on art activities, live music, nice. Which is super fun. So we try to cover all of the arts. We call it Arts in the Street, mm-hmm. not just art. We have some dance performances and beer and wine. We have that too. So it's just a really fun day in downtown Plymouth, a way to support local art and artists and just, you know, have a great time and, you know, maybe try out a couple things while you're down here.
That's so fun.
Yeah.
Anna, thank you.
Well, thank you,
so
Cindy.
Fun.
I appreciate it. Oh, this is great.
Yeah, thank
love
you.
This program.
All right.
Thanks so much.